build it by clicking on the ground near your colonists. Colonists require a constant supply of food rations to survive. Keep an eye on your resource production at the top of the screen. A negative production number means that you are consuming more than you are producing. In order to produce food rations, you will need to build farms and assign colonists to them. Once you have a supply of food rations, you can recruit more colonists through the command center. Now that you have your food production established, it is time to start collecting resources. Let's start by collecting iron and manufacturing into usable parts. Locate an iron deposit near your command center and build a miner to start extracting the iron. An iron fabricator is needed to process the iron into parts that can be used for constructing buildings and building mechs. Defeating enemy bases will require combat units. Combat-ready mechs are essential in expanding your colony. Mechs require energy cells in order to build. To build energy cells, you will need to process copper at an energy manufacturer. Build the necessary buildings to collect copper and produce energy cells. Ongoing energy cell production is required to keep your mechs operating. As you start building mechs, be sure to keep an eye on your production in order to keep it in the green. Once you have mechs built, you can use them to invade the enemy camp and destroy them to eliminate them from this planet.
Thank you.
You have destroyed the enemy colony and have taken control of this planet. Next, we will establish your space operations to invade the nearby planet. Press Tab on the keyboard to switch between the planet and space. Once in space, use the Build menu at the bottom left of the screen to build a space station.
Advancing to position. Moving out. Advancing to position.
Acquiring target! Target locked! Target locked!
Thank you.
Setting course. Course set. Going now. Moving there now. We are on our way. We are on our way. Moving there now.